Welcome back to the black carpet. This is the Necrosexual for Metal Sucks at the Revolver Music Awards. And I am here with the Dillinger Escape Plan. Ben, how the hell are you tonight?
I'm good. Very good.
Oh, I'm good! It's a beautiful falsetto, sir. So you're...
It's a nice squeal.
So you're in the midst of your farewell tour. People have been going crazy for Dillinger on this tour. Tell us about some of the craziness you've seen at the stage.
Man, that was somebody threw an alligator at us one night. Straight up. It was fucking boom. He got a maxi pad stuck to the side of his head one night. Probably. What about you?
Well, I think the same maxi pad fell off of him, and I got the adhesive side. And I got to wear it for the rest of the show. So that was a good side. Yeah, you got the red side. You got the U side. Right.
They're like just really like giant basement shows, basically. Well, that's what it is.
Alligators and hats and basements. Totally brutal. So when the door finally closes on that chapter of your life called the Dillinger Escape Plan for now, how do you hope people will look back and think of your band?
They probably won't look back at all. I think I would like people to feel like we were a band that just kind of did it our way to the end. Like, just did it the way we wanted to do it from day one to the last day.
He did it his way.
Can you do that one more?
He did it his way. Yeah, for the ladies. And tell us about your new project, Giraffe Tongue Orchestra.
Yeah, it was something I've been working on with Brent Hines for a really long time. Finally ran it out and got a bunch of awesome guys to play with and put it out. And it was kind of one of those things where just getting out was accomplishing the goal because it was so hard to get logistically done. But now we're really happy with it. We played, getting ready to play some shows. And you know what I mean?
What do you have to say to your fans that are going to see on the farewell tour?
What are they going to see?
What are you going to say to your fans?
What am I going to say? We don't really say shit. We say it with our music, you know? I mean, we usually speak about 15 minutes between each song about some political thing, Trump, you know, all that. Then we go into the Christian rant, and then we pass a hat around and try to get, you know. We really don't say much.
Ben, thank you for going one-on-one with the Grim One.
Thank you.
I'm going to grab Kevin over here. Kevin!
We're big fans.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it. So, Kevin, how the hell are you, my friend?
Good, man. It's been a minute. I've seen you.
It's been a minute. You know, I got to give Kevin, I got to give you a lot of credit because every February you let me invade your house and torture you.
Yeah.
So what's brewing at Backroom Studio?
Oh, a lot of work, man. We're busy as shit. We got a bunch of new hired guys, and we're just cranking out record after record. So
I can't wait to squat at your house at Backroom and play your video games till you kick me out. Now, Kevin is also a big fan of Star Wars, as am I, the dark side.
Yeah.
What do you think of Rogue One? It's coming out soon. What are your forecasts?
I'm good. It's going to be awesome. It's got Disney money behind it. It's going to be awesome.
Yeah, Disney money. I sleep on a bed of black metal money. It's just dirt. But here's my fan theory for Rogue One, Kevin. We're going to break script for a second. I think that it's implied that Mads Mikkelsen's character is the guy that built the Death Star, right? And his daughter joins the Resistance. So my theory is that he intentionally made there a single trash vent. He was the one that made it so easily destroyed so his daughter could blow it up.
Yeah. Okay.
It would make sense, like, why there would be, like, a single trash vent that could blow up an entire Death Star.
Yeah, the size of a moon.
That's my theory. Take it to the bank. We're going to find out on Friday, Rogue One. What do you hope the new year holds for you, Kevin?
I hope that movie's good. A lot of touring. I don't know. A lot of fun stuff. Everything's good. Can't complain.
Touring Star Wars, the Necrosexual invading your house. Kevin, thank you for going one-on-one with the Grim One. I'll see you soon.
Right.
It is I, the Slayer of Posers, the Grim One to all, the most electrifying man in corpse entertainment, the Necrosexual!